Welcome to City Block the Birch. We start at the address Storgatan, number 29. Number 27. Börjesson and Company built this house after several ventures with landshövdingehus in Landala. Storgatan, number 25. This elaborate facade was designed by architect Louis Enders. Builder Joachim Dähn constructed it in 1890. As the names suggest, they were both Germans. And the style of this house is so German it might have been plucked right from the 1880s Berlin or Dresden, which is where they both came from. Just look at that spire. This jutting part is apparently called an erker. It is supported by colonnettes made from black porphyry. The building continues round the corner at Erik Dahlbergsgatan, number 4. And number 6. Note the griffins under the modern roof box. J.A. Westerberg designed and built this house in 1889. The client was August Hollander, whose initials we see here. Erik Dahlbergsgatan, number 8. The condo association that owns number 6 and 8 say that this house was built by joiners Nilsson and Johansson in 1888. They did a fine job and the association must really love it, considering how much the maintenance must cost. Erik Dahlbergsgatan, number 10. Round about here, there was a mill and a mill pond in the olden days. If this block was built on a stream bed, that would explain why there is so much subsidence damage. as seen on the facades along Vasaplatsen, for instance. Erik Dahlbergsgatan number 12. A plaque commemorating Beatrice Dixon, who led many charitable works. This house was built in 1887 and designed by Hjalmar Cornelsen. It is now a condo association and a two-room flat recently sold for 4 million crowns. Erik Dahlbergsgatan number 14. Owls on the prowl. Ernst Krüger designed and built this house with his father August in 1887. The current tenants are almost all medical, including dentists. The building continues round the corner at Vasagatan number 32. Number 34. The middle house here was built by Anders Johansson. The three houses along Vasagatan were built step-like, rising from left to right. Vasagatan number 36. There's a painted frieze under the roof, but the zoom just makes it blurry. The style is described as Dutch-German Renaissance, or Viennese. Pastry chef cum builder extraordinaire Ernst Frommel had this skyscraper built in 1887. It was long the only one on the block and something to marvel at with all the decorations. Almost like an elaborate wedding cake. The building continues round the corner at Vasaplatsen number 13. Frommel certainly didn't go for the humble look on the front of his house. Vasaplatsen number 11. The middle section of this side of the block was built as two sets of twins. Both pairs designed by architect Carl Fahlström. Numbers 11 and 9 were built by Janne Johansson in 1896. Vasaplatsen number 9. Number 7. Numbers 7 and 5 were built by Olof Andreas Burman, also in 1896. Burman normally built landshövdingehus, but wanted to strut his stuff here. The tall spires that originally crowned these two buildings have since been removed. Vasaplatsen number 5. When these two houses were built in 1896, it was during a hectic building boom. Corners were cut to make savings, just like today. So many corners, in fact, that the buildings became fire hazards. Legal action was sought against Burman after a nasty fire in 1898. Vasaplatsen number 3. This big house was built for trader Otto Berlin in 1896. Could this be Mrs. Berlin? C.B. Andersson, who built the house, autographed another one on the other side of Vasaplatsen, as seen in part 142 of this series. After a quick haircut, we sashay over to part 146 and the city block called the Curly Birch.